Determining the optimal transcription factor binding site can be pretty difficult and usually has to be determined empirically. What that means is we normally have to go to the lab to figure it out. But that's not always an easy thing to do, and sometimes it's a little faster to do what we call sequence comparisons or sequence alignments. What this means is instead of going into the lab, I'm going to take, let's say, 5 or 6 different individuals, and I'm going to take the transcription factor binding site sequence for this person and that person and that person and that person, and I'm going to line them all up together, one on top of the other. For instance, I have these 6 sequences right here, hypothetically speaking, of course, from 6 different individuals. And when you line them all up like this, hopefully what you notice first off is that there are very few differences in the overall sequences. But at any given position, you can see that there's a dominant nucleotide in that column. We call this the consensus or the agreement, right? Because most of the letters in that column are one letter or another. So what I want you to try to do right now is looking at these 6 sequence alignments. Tell me what you think the consensus sequence is for this transcription factor binding site.